lightning. Displays of static electricity in our atmosphere, common to us all. But as beautiful and impressive as these displays are, they represent a most powerful and destructive force. Here's another good example of static electricity. Did you catch that? Let's see it again. No, not quite as impressive as lightning, but powerful and destructive in its own way. With electronic components every day. Electronic components that are highly sensitive to the damaging effects of static electricity. One of the most sensitive components that you come in contact with on your job is the metal oxide semiconductor, or simply the MOS device. This tiny device is a key component in many of the telephone systems we produce. And when one of these sensitive devices comes in contact with static electricity, well, it goes something like this. Exaggeration? Not really. It's all just a matter of perspective. As little as 50 volts of static electricity can destroy a MOS device. So the system it's meant to work in sooner or later will fail. Just 50 volts. But did you know that you can carry about 3,000 to 3,500 volts of static electricity around with you every day? When unleashed, it can destroy a MOS device with the touch of a finger. It's not difficult to spot a static sensitive device. It's simply a matter of knowing what to look for. Component number FD1079 is an immediate signal that you're working with a MOS device. Of course, the letters MOS signal static sensitivity too. But the most common signal you can look for is the color red. Red indicates that the individual component or PWC that you're working on is static sensitive, and precautions must be taken against static damage. Let's quickly go over what we've covered so far. Static electricity can be the unseen, unheard killer of sensitive electronic devices which you must handle every day, especially the MOS device. You can identify the MOS device by the component number FD1079, the letters MOS, or by the color red on the printed wiring card assembly, or the component itself. Now, let's look at some of the precautions that are necessary when handling or working around static-sensitive devices. They're easy to remember. Just think of the letters MOS. M, minimize handling. O, only handle when grounded. And S, stay away from untreated plastics. Now, let's take a closer look at each of these precautions. Minimize handling. To do this, keep parts in their original containers whenever possible, and return the card to its proper container as soon as completed. Use protective bags or protective containers for storage and transport of components and assemblies. Hold static-sensitive cards and components by the body or by the edges. Never pick up a card by the components or touch the contact tabs. Next, only handle when grounded. By using some form of grounding device, such as this wrist strap, you neutralize your body's electrical charge so it cannot cause static damage. It must be in contact with your skin because your skin is what conducts the static charge from your clothing and surroundings to the materials you touch. The strap must then be attached to the ground point at your workstation. Your work area can be another main cause of static damage if not properly equipped. Grounded mats, special soldering tools, and other equipment designed to reduce static electricity must be used when around static-sensitive devices. In this way, both you and your work area are connected to a common ground which neutralizes the chance of damage to static-sensitive devices. And finally, stay away from untreated plastics. One of the best generators of static electricity is untreated plastic. When placed too close to a static-sensitive device, it can easily destroy it. Plastic covers on job sheets, styrofoam, and vinyls of all types, which are not specially treated, must be avoided at all times. Again, minimize handling, only handle when grounded, and stay away from untreated plastics. MOS. An easy way to remember just how important it is to take these three major precautions against damage to MOS devices. In the following work situation, try to identify these precautionary measures in action. One can tell that these are static-sensitive cards by the color red on the edges and by the red lettering on the card handles. By attaching the wrist strap so it touches the skin and is connected to the ground point at the workstation, this worker is now neutralized, thus protecting the MOS from static damage. The card is handled carefully by the body and edges, and the station is properly equipped. If it's necessary to refer to a job sheet or handle plastics, this worker takes care not to let it come anywhere near the card, and care is taken to stay grounded until the card is completely returned to its original container. During this next example, check the precautions this worker takes, and make note if you see any that are missed. Did you notice anything wrong? Let's go over the example together. It's easy to identify that this is a static-sensitive card by the packaging. But look, it's being handled without the worker being grounded. That's better. Uh-oh, get that plastic away from those components. Okay. No, don't touch that card. The job is finished, but by now, so is that MOS device. Static damage can be caused by plastics, an improperly prepared work surface, and most importantly, you if you're not aware how to prevent it. know how to identify static-sensitive devices by component number FD-1079, red warning markings, or the letters MOS. And remember the MOS rules. Minimize handling using proper containers, work surfaces, and holding procedures. Only handle when grounded by making sure your wrist strap is touching your skin and is properly connected to the common ground point at your workstation. And stay away from untreated plastics or other untreated vinyls and styrofoams in your work area. Know how to prevent static damage to the MOS device. It means the difference between a product that works and one that doesn't. And let's face it, only you can properly handle such a sensitive situation.